What up, world? I got this Big Sean review, Hall of Fame. This is Big Sean's sophomore album for 2013, man. This is like good music. I want to say like third of five releases this year. If you count Kid Cudi, that indie cut, Kanye's whack ass shit, this, John Legend just dropped that Love in the Future. And then Pusha T about to drop My Name Is My Name. Like I said, man, Sean's sophomore album. I didn't get to review Finally Famous. I think Finally Famous is a dope ass album though. Like I Do It. That track was perfect for that Derrick Rose Adidas commercial. But let's go ahead. Let's jump into this shit right now. Track number one is called Nothing Is Stopping You. That little robotic Nothing Is Stopping You. That shit is dope as hell to me. And ironically, Sean is rapping about getting delayed and getting stopped like everywhere he goes on his way to where he's going. But ultimately he meeting his goal, you know what I'm saying? So I like the irony in that song. The beat is dope. No ID produced a lot of these tracks. Most of the production was handled by Key Wayne, who did this, and No ID. This is a pretty dope way to start off his album. Track number two is called Fire, and Fire I think was the first official single. It's the music video. They got Miley Cyrus in it. Like Sean, I don't even think Sean is in it. I watched the video like one time, and Miley Cyrus is in it for the most part, which was weird. Man, don't even get me on Miley Cyrus right now, man. Fuck that. If y'all seen my top five albums of summer, when I talked about that Magna Carta Holy Grail, I spoke on Miley Cyrus. You feel what I'm saying? For a single, I like a lot of Sean bars in this track. Like lyrically, he saved some good punchlines for this track. The horror movie Cutthroat shit is one off the top of my head. I mean, listen to this track, man. Watch the video on YouTube and you'll know what I'm talking about. Track number three is called 10 to 10. And one day I'm going to be a dickhead. I live in a town on the Mexico border, man. So I'm going to play 10 to 10 and just roll down the street with my windows down. And at the time, Sean talking about, I'm putting in work like a Mexican. My lady heard that track. She got to, like, she was joking, but she acted offended. This track is silly. I mean, he's talking about putting in work, obviously. You know what I'm saying? 12-hour work days. To take a phrase from Wale, man, no days off. Sean is really just talking about surviving in this motherfucker, man. Like, that's what life is about, is survival. Am I right? Track number four is Toyota Music. I really don't like this track. Because I feel like if it's called Toyota Music, Sean should be rapping about cars. But, like, there's a lot of shit where he's just rapping. And there's part of it where he's talking about his family. Like, talking about providing for his family and shit. Track number five is called You Don't Know. And this is, like, the way that a female feels after messing with Big Sean. That's what I took from it. Like the chorus say some shit about you don't know. Like, you don't know what you do to me once you inside or some shit. This shit is visually descriptive. If you can't get a visual off of that shit, then fucking turn the radio off, bro. I mean, it's a cool song. Like I said earlier, man, produced by No ID. I mean, No ID is one of my favorite producers at the moment, man. Him, Jake One. Just motherfuckers who don't make beats who outshine the lyrics, you know what I'm saying? Like, the lyrics and the beat is supposed to fuse together in the track and become one, you know what I mean? Track number six is called Beware. And I'm not sure if this was a single. It's got Lil Wayne on it, so I'm sure it will be. But it's on some, Sean broke up with this chick, so Beware, what they say, he'll have no fury like a woman scorned type shit. It's a cool little track. Like Sean has a topic, and he's rapping about that topic, you know? It's on some revenge shit, chick wants payback. He basically hit it and quit it, you know what I'm saying? Smashed and dashed, if you will. Lil Wayne versus decent. And when I say decent, Wayne had like one dope line, and it was like the French gator pussy, a French kiss or whatever. He always rapping about pussy, man. The motherfucker got like 27 baby moms though. I mean, what else is he gonna rap about? Track 7 is called First Chain. Nas and Kid Cudi is on this, and Sean is talking about how his life changed once he got his first chain. I like this track because Nas kills everything. Like, if you follow me on Instagram, then you've seen my top 5 dead or alive, and I kept it alive. I ain't want to cause no controversy, and I had Nas 3, and then Cudi, I really didn't pick up that he was rapping about his first chain. And I'm also curious whether Cudi recorded this verse when he was still on Good Music or since he left. Because, I mean, at the end of the verse, he say it's Good Music forever. I like this song, man. Track 8, it's basically a track about fucking. It's called Mona Lisa. And, like, the chorus goes, Mona Lisa, Lisa moaning. But then he rapping about smoking. He rapping about drinking and shit. You know what I'm saying? It's an ignorant song that you can have fun with. The first portion of this album, Sean really been like on some material shit, which is cool, cause I mean, the kids don't want to hear about real shit. Kids want to hear about having fun. So I mean, that's the majority of what Sean is talking about, having fun. Track 9 is called Freaky. It's a skit. Off top of my head, I don't remember where he saw it from. It's on Wikipedia. But just some wild ass chick talking about another man's dick, and talking about how the coochie get when she see it and shit, which leads into track 10 called MILF with Nicki Minaj and Juicy J on it. And I mean, MILF is an acronym for Mom I Like to Fuck. And I mean, thank American Pie for that shit, because before American Pie, that shit didn't even exist. But clearly, I mean, you know what Sean is talking about. He's talking about smashing moms. And I don't know if it's a sample. I don't know if it's like some background motherfuckers. But at Nah, not my mama. That shit was cool. Like, it fit the beat. It was kind of funny. And like, Sean verse is cool. Sean, like, he'll have some bars that are straight bullshit, but then he'll have some bars like that are dope, you know what I mean? Like, Sean is damn near a 50-50 rapper. You never know what you're gonna get from him. You never know if he's gonna come in killing, or if he's gonna like half-ass and like create some half-ass rhyme. Nicki Minaj, man. If y'all follow my reviews, y'all know I despise Nicki Minaj. While she can rap, I feel like anybody can rap. And while she shit on Lil Kim and say that she wasn't like Lil Kim, she's taking Lil Kim and Trina whole shtick. Every verse I hear from her, she talking about how good the ass is. Like Missy need to sit down with some of these female rappers and teach them how to rap about more than just the ass. Maybe to give her some credit, maybe she was the MILF in this track, and while Sean is talking about smashing the MILF, she's talking about smashing too. But she's talking about doing crack, and she's talking about, like, she just starts talking, man. I just feel like she's a fucking cartoon character. On to Juicy J, man, before I fucking get discouraged. Juicy J is basically like following Sean's lead. He's talking about like seducing bitches, taking them back to the crib and fucking. That's what this type of song is, you know what I'm saying? It's like, it's cool, it's not my favorite. Track 11 is called Sierra Leone, and at the end it has a skit called Greedy Hoes. At first, Sierra Leone, it starts off with a Nas soundbite, but the Nas soundbite is from First Chain, which is cool. Like, I think that shit is dope as fuck. Like, Wayne and Birdman, I think, did that shit where they took like some of Wayne bars from, I think, a track from The Carter, and they used it for a chorus on like Father Like Son. Well, Sean took a Nas line from like three tracks ago and used it to intro to Sierra Leone. But while Big Sean could have used Sierra Leone to kind of be like Diamonds, like Kanye did on Late Registration, he uses it as a track to entertain bitches. He's talking about entertaining bitches, top floor in a hotel, and everything covered in jewelry, basically. Like, we 11 tracks in out of 15, and like every track has really been on some material, superficial, just ignorant shit, really. Depending on your flavor, I guess that's not really a bad thing. As far as my flavor, you know, I want to hear some shit a little more thought provoking, because I know the type of potential Big Sean got. Track number 12 is called "It's Time," and he really talking about putting on for Detroit, man, putting on for his city. And Detroit is going through a lot of fucked up shit right now. But this is more of a hype, energetic track. Young Jeezy is on this track. I know he dropped Young from his name, but I've been rolling with the motherfucker ever since Let's Get It, Thug Motivation 101 came out. So I'm calling that motherfucker Young Jeezy even when he's 50. And he's on here just rapping. I mean, for Jeezy, it's a decent verse. He's talking about stunting, splurging, spending money. The typical Young Jeezy topics. And then it's a cat named Payroll on this song. And he comes cool. He just sounds a lot like Too Short. It's a straight track, once again. I mean, the same as most of these tracks. Like, they're just there. Like, there's a lot of songs that, like, they're cool. They're nothing spectacular. They're, like, not totally garbage. They're just there. Track 13 is called World Ablaze. And this is where, like, for the last sixth of this album, Sean, like, gets real. And he starts talking about, like, real feelings and real situations and shit. In the first verse on World Ablaze, he talking about how his mom telling him to be careful, how his homeboy from the hood got shot just walking down the street. And then the second verse, he talking about an ex-chick or a current chick. I mean, Sean is fucking with a chick from Glee, if I'm not mistaken. But I don't think he talking about her. I think he talking about a chick that he knew or used to fuck around with. And her mom is sick, and it's spreading throughout her body and shit. And he's just trying to be there and console her. This is one of the doper tracks on the entire album, World Ablaze. Track number 14 is called Ashley. And he's rapping to an ex-girl. And basically kind of just apologizing for doing her dirty and shit. He said, "You ain't supposed to have your cake and eat it too, but it's funny how these hoes kept my plate full." I mean, he admitting his mistakes, man. He owning up to his faults. Once again, this track is dope. Miguel is on the chorus. And when R&B singers curse and sing at the same time, like, I don't like that shit. So, like, the hook could have been a little better. But overall, it's a good track. Last track, track number 15, is called All Figured Out. And he's talking about, because he's on, because he's rich, because he has money, everybody think that he know exactly what he doing and he got all the answers and all this type of shit. Yeah, that's not true. Everybody know that shit. That type of shit's not true. Motherfuckers like Bill Gates still running into struggle. You know what I'm saying? Like Oprah with that situation that happened overseas. Like, motherfuckers all shapes, sizes, currencies run into trouble, man. And also he's speaking on, if a motherfucker did not help you reach your goal, ignore every type of shit that they talking about when it comes to what they think you should do. Because if a motherfucker didn't help you get where you want to be, anything they got to say is bullshit. That's it. If you follow my shit, you know, I don't fuck with deluxe versions. I feel like if it didn't make the main pressing, the pressing of the main album, it's not part of the album. So, with that being said, man, I want to say Hall of Fame is straight. I wanted to like it better, but when I thoroughly looked at this album, and heard every track, it just had potential to be so much more. Like I said, like, Sean is a 50-50 rapper. For, like, every two lines that are dope, he got, like, six that are half-assed and that are, like, that he's reaching to make a punchline, you know what I'm saying? And 15 tracks, I want to say 12 of them are, like, materialistic, superficial, ignorant-ass flows. And then he got, like, three songs that are, like, real, like, heartfelt tracks. Like, Juicy J, Nicki Minaj, man, these are features I can't fuck with. Nas is on here, and that's like, the only good feature. Like, Cudi was an in-the-middle feature. Cudi wasn't a whack feature. Cudi wasn't a dope feature. And Wayne wasn't whack, surprisingly. But he didn't like, have 16 bars of heat. So I want to know how y'all feel, man. What's y'all favorite track on Hall of Fame? I'm gonna go with the Nas track, man. I think First Chain is probably one of my favorites, or World Ablaze. World Ablaze and First Chain are probably the two best tracks on this album. And also, do you prefer Finally Famous or Hall of Fame? I prefer Finally Famous. Check out my Riddick movie review I posted yesterday. Check out my NFL prediction video I did with my man Orlando Penner. Leave feedback, man. Hit me on Facebook, Randy Little Music. Stay tuned for my flows. Peace.